she had any unfinished business that she wanted done. She said, help me plan my funeral. Not what I was expecting. She said, my kids can't talk about it. So we talked about the songs that she wanted sung, the scriptures she wanted read, and the pastor that she wanted to conduct her service. I called the pastor, and he was surprised, but happy to come in. And he planned the details with her. She survived for another few weeks, but she, her family, and the pastor, during that time, were able to talk about her funeral and many other things, and she was smiling the whole time. Story three. Some years later, I admitted a young man who had been thrown from a car due to a motor vehicle accident, and he was found by the first responders, severely injured and up in a tree. Had multiple fractures of both legs, pelvis, left arm, internal injuries that required emergency surgery, and then a long recovery in ICU, hospital and rehab followed. Now, I want you to picture this because she kind of is part of the story. Imagine this young man just moved into the ICU bed, hurt terribly, of course, had a cervical collar on his neck, both legs were in suspended traction. I know, old-fashioned, right? Left arm passive, right arm restrained so that he couldn't pull out the chest tubes, the breathing tube, the stomach tube, so on, the IVs and all. And laceration is still bleeding everywhere. We were in a flurry of activity to get him stabilized, everything connected and working, and assessed to make sure we were doing the right things for him. As he lay there wide awake, unable to speak because of the tubes, watching everything with wide, frightened eyes, unable to speak because, of course, tubes in his mouth, tubes in his nose, and so on. I remember keeping a constant stream of conversation going with him about where he was, what we were doing to him, that we were going to get his pain under control and get him settled. Well, he didn't settle. Even after I gave him pain medicine several times, reassured him that he was doing okay, that his family was on their way, and so on. So I asked him if he was having plank pain. Blink once for yes, twice for no. He blinked once. Yes, he was having pain. Is it in your left leg? He blinked no. Is it in your right leg? He blinked no. And on and on and on, and he went all the way through his whole body systems. No, 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 no. He was frustrated. He wanted to talk to me. I knew that, but couldn't. So with his eyes, which was about all he could move at that time, he indicated his right hand and his right arm. It took me another 20 minutes or better to finally figure out that he had a splinter in his finger that was driving him crazy. When I removed the splinter, he let out a big sigh, if you can do that on a ventilator. Closed his eyes and slept for a little while. How are these stories even related? Well, I hope they demonstrate to you a few characteristics I think you can build your foundation of caring for your community on. Be compassionate. Compassion means you believe your patient, care what happens to them in the toughest of situations, intervene when it is difficult, and move yourself out of the way so that you can do the right thing for them. Stay competent. That means that you always have to continue learning. Sorry, you thought you were done. Otherwise, you'll be outdated in your knowledge and skills in 5 years. That is a research fact. Yes, I encourage you to complete your advanced nursing degrees. We will need good nursing instructors, educators, when you're ready. And yes, there are conferences, trainings, magazines. I know they're not made out of paper anymore, right? But anyway, lots of ways you can do it. But the ways that I want to impress upon you are fairly simple. When you have a patient that comes in with a diagnosis that you haven't seen recently or ever, take a few minutes, look up the patho, the common symptoms and common treatments. You'll at least go in with a handful of knowledge about that disease and the ability to assess with the skills that you've already gained. And the last of these symptoms. something more simple. I want you to be able to answer these three questions early on each shift for every patient that you care for. What is the worst thing that could happen to this person today because of their disease or disorder? How can I prevent that from happening? And how do I assess for it? The third thing, be persistent. Persist for your patients and for your profession's sake to figure out the problems, to advocate for patients when they can't speak for themselves, to plan and implement solutions. Oh, that sounds sort of like nursing process, right? You thought you were done with it. No. The plan of care may not always be some of the more exciting interventions or procedures or current cutting-edge technology. Remember, it may be time in the bedside, planning a funeral, or removing a splinter. I told you three of many stories of my nursing experience in my community of care. What will your stories be? Who will be your community of care? It could literally be a whole community in public health nursing, or a select group of clients in a GI lab. It could be at the beginning of life in a newborn nursery, or at the end in long-term care or hospice, or any of a myriad of communities of people for whom you choose to build your stories with. I challenge you to provide care with sharp, current knowledge and skills, persistence, and compassion. Because, nurses, there's a community out there who need you providing your best care. Congratulations and welcome to the profession.
Day, your week, your month, even though you live. misunderstanding, I'd absolutely not be here if I enjoyed this moment. Finally, I want to congratulate everyone who made it to this point. We all have faced our own struggles and rose to the occasion to unlock the door of opportunity that will last the rest of our lives. Sister Lisa, I couldn't be more thankful for having you by my side to go through this journey with. all kept me going, and I love you all for that.
Thank you.
Callie, and Michelle. It means the world to have you all here. Justice Manchego.
Here we are at the end of the road. I look forward to sharing nursing stories with you in the near future.
First and foremost, happy birthday to my brother, and I would like to thank God for guiding me along this journey in life. Next, my boys for giving me the strength to keep pushing when I felt like giving up. And finally, my fiance and family for dealing with my craziness for these years. It has been a wild ride, and congratulations to the Nursing RN class of 2022. You did it. I could not have done this without you, and we have made so many awesome memories together. Mostly, I want to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for him and all things. Our thoughts.
Take a moment to To pass my life in purity. And to practice my profession faithfully. I will abstain from whatever is deleterious and mischievous. And will not take or administer any harmful drug. I will do all in my power to maintain and elevate the standard of my profession. And will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping. And all family affairs coming to my knowledge in the practice of my calling. With loyalty, I will endeavor to aid the physician in their work. And devote myself to the welfare of those committed to my care.
Geropologist 2022 non-traditional RN class.